Tags are the keywords which you want to be found for. Through tags, you tell YouTube that they should be returning your videos when the viewers type in those keywords in the search bar. But the tags are only for YouTube and the search engines. The tags are not visible to the viewer. Only search engines like Google or Bing can see the tags, or YouTube can see the tags. Search engines consider the tags as suggestions for ranking. So if you're targeting a certain tag, the search engine will understand that you want to be ranked for that tag, and based on your video stats or on other stats and other factors, the search engine or YouTube will rank your video and you will be able to reach out to more people. In the tags, the best strategy is to target as many tags as possible. YouTube will give you about 540 characters, which is good enough to have about 15 to 16 tags depending on the size of each tag that you're targeting. So make sure that you target all these 15-16 tags. I have found that very often people are targeting only 3 to 4 or maybe 5-6 tags, but they should be making the use of this opportunity and making sure that they target as many tags as possible. When you target tags, I want you to keep in mind that you shouldn't be targeting the very popular, the very high traffic tags right in the beginning, because your video is quite new, it's quite raw, there are no stats for it, there is no ranking for it. That's why it's a very difficult task for this video to rank for the highly competitive high traffic tags. What you should be doing instead is to target the less competitive long tail tags. Now the long tail tags are searched a bit less often and you will get a lesser amount of traffic from them, but they're also very less or they're also very low in competition, and you will find it easier to rank for them. So once your videos are ranking for the low end, the long tail tags, and you are already getting views, you're already building up the stats, the likes, the dislikes, the comments, the favorites, and every other stat possible, your video will start climbing, it will start becoming more valuable, and when you target the more competitive tags later, it will start climbing and appearing higher up on the search results. But the idea is to be found, and if you target these keywords right in the beginning, you will never be found for these keywords and you will get absolutely no search results. So target the long tail tags first and in a massive manner. But always make sure that you target at least 2 to 3 high traffic tags in the tags that you target. Now, as I told you earlier, YouTube gives you a space to target about 14 to 16 tags in all. So maybe 10 of those can be the long tail tags and 2-3 can be the high traffic tags. This will help you ensure that once your video gathers the stats, once your video is more valuable, it will start ranking automatically for the high-end tracks that you're targeting. And trust me, when you create a video, you don't need to be returned, or you don't need to rank for 10 high-value tags. In fact, that's impossible, or very nearly impossible if you are not a huge channel. But it's very good if you're ranking even for 2 to 3 tags and your video will be very popular. So this is the tag strategy that I use in my own videos, which has worked very well for me, and it will work well for you too. Alright, so let's go back to our older example and check out the tags. Let's see how to put in tags for that one. So we were talking about Christmas dishes, and actually I have some tags already sorted out with my research, and I'm just gonna paste them here, and that's probably what you should do. And these are about 10 or 12 tags which I've put in, and all of them are relevant to the niche that I've selected. And this is how your tags are going to look. You can put in fresh tags by just typing them like this or pasting them. Don't go with the tags that YouTube suggests. They are really crappy. You don't want to go with them at all. They're irrelevant. And the biggest mistake that people do on YouTube while putting in tags is use these tags. Don't ever use these tags, they're useless. Right, so let's just put in a couple more tags.
I'm just using a comma to separate the tags, which will nicely separate them into different new tags. Alright, so put a comma and it automatically turns into a new tag. And you can remove tags by clicking on the little cross over here, so it's easy. And once you're done, just click on save changes like this. Right, all changes have been saved. Now, you can see that I've put in these many tags, but there's probably room for more, so we're gonna target all of them. Christmas cooking recipe ideas. Christmas recipes. Quick. I'm just making tags on my own right now, but that's not what you should do. You should research them. Okay, so let's check again. Save changes. Right, now you see it says some changes have not yet been saved. And the reason is your setting could not be saved. Your tags are too long. So when you actually go over the limit, YouTube will tell you that your tags are too long. So that's when I actually start removing tags. I will remove one tag, try again. All right, so this is my process. This is what I do. This is what I think should be done. Put in tags as many as you can till the time you overflow the limit or you go over the limit, and then start removing the tags that you feel are the least relevant or the most or the least useful. So that way you will have the maximum number of tags possible, which is what we want when we do tagging for our videos.